The hospital bag. The travel bag. The hospital bag. Hello, y'all. I'm Diana Brienne. Well, what am I talking about today? Y'all know I talk about just about everything. I don't give advice. I don't give suggestions. I just share with you my perspective on different topics. So today it's called the hospital bag or the travel bag, whichever you want to call it. And, you know, I'm going to give you a little back history about the hospital bag. About 10 years ago, I suddenly took sick. As you all know, go look up the story called brain aneurysm. I'm fine today. And, but I did take sick and I ended up in the hospital. And I learned something after that, or before that, is to always keep a hospital bag ready, a just-in-case bag. It could be for not just the hospital, but it could be for any other kind of sudden type of thing that we just have to up and go. And so I keep a hospital bag, and with my makeup, my toothbrush, all, you know, brand new makeup, all brand new toothbrush, you know, underwear, bras, panties, nightgown, anything that I would need at the hospital, I keep that. And I have it like in little baggies sealed up, so it's all neat and I can easily get to it if I need to. And all I would have to do is pick up and run, so to speak, if I needed to go. When my daughter took sick 3 years ago, it was a suddenly. She had to be rushed by ambulance to a major university hospital. Y'all know that story called portal vein thrombosis. It was a suddenly and unexpected, unforeseen event. Had to have major life-saving surgery. She's doing fine today, minus a few little issues from it, but otherwise she's doing great. And so this is the thing about the hospital bag. After that, after actually both occasions, I kept a hospital bag in my room or by the door for the longest time. It was sort of like PTSD of thinking I was going to have to go back to the hospital suddenly. So I kept a hospital bag, I think for about 2 years after I had taken sick, and about a year after my daughter taken sick, I kept one nearby, completely ready to go. And that included next to it my laptop. It included my purse with my cell phone, my charger, an extra charger. Anything that I would need, and I would need it suddenly and I wouldn't have time to really think about it. And I also have a separate kind of bag packed. And as you all know, we have a little beach house that we raised our children in part of the time when they were little. And so we periodically renovated it. Now we go back as a family periodically. And so I have a bag ready to go. I call it my beach bag, but it's actually, you know, with everything I need so that I don't have to package time, so that it's all ready, it's organized, it's neat, it's in Ziploc bags, you know, and it's a bag. It's not really a suitcase. And then if I want extra stuff, I can, you know, pack the suitcase if that's what I want to do, have an additional suitcase. But I have a kind of a suddenly bag, or like, hey, let's go to Tybee. Oh, I'm not ready. Okay, I'm ready. Even at a bare minimum, I'm ready. So, you know, that's Tybee Island. And so I have my, you know, my hospital bag for just in case, or it could be for any other reason. Like I said, you know, maybe my husband might come home and say, hey, let's go away for the weekend. Let's take off, you know, and in situations like that, I'm all ready. And so, but that's kind of the history of the hospital bag with me. It was more of a trauma response, a PTSD thing, that I kept the hospital bag ready to go, kept all my stuff either next to my bed or next to the front door, in, you know, in case I had to go back to the hospital with my daughter, or in my situation, with my situation 10 years ago. And so I kept that. But even today now, you know, turning almost 64, I'm not 64 yet, but almost, I feel that it's always good to be prepared for the what ifs. And so I've gone back to creating a hospital bag, or a suddenly bag. I've also gone back to creating, you know, my overnight bag for, you know, if we go to, you know, go to our little vacation house, or if we go somewhere else, you know, kind of suddenly on this, you know, quick moment, I'm ready to go. So I have those two separate kind of bags. And then, you know, you can always, if you have more time, then you can add to that with a suitcase or whatever you want. But it's good to have the bare minimum of what you might need in any kind of event. So that's where that came from. And so I'm actually working on it. I have some nice bags and I'm working on it. You know, they're big bags. They're like, you know, they're the kind that you can put a lot of stuff into. And I've always carried a big purse, so I also have a big purse. Anyhow, I hope to talk to you soon again. May God bless you. I hope you like, share, subscribe to all 5 of my channels. Links are pinned at the top of the comment section below. If you connect with me with all 5 channels, I will likely connect back with you with all 5 channels. Hope to talk to you then. May God bless you. Bye-bye.